Yo ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the video. Today we are going to be making a very interesting project which I actually saw online, and not actually a project which I actually saw online, but an experiment which I've been wondering to create. Can we actually ignite fire using water? Just water? Yeah, that's a question that needs to be asked, and that is what we're going to be doing today. We are going to be creating fire out of water. The process is really long, so you all to stay to the ending of this video to get great insight and full tutorial. Let's dive in. Now, to be able to create fire or to ignite fire out of water, we need a couple of components which we are going to be using. First off, we are going to be using this nut and bolt right here. We're going to be using nut and bolt in this video. We are going to be using a container to put everything in place and to secure everything as usual. And also, we are going to be using salt as also in this experiment, because this is actually a science experiment, and a couple of wires which is going to be connected as we go on the project. And yeah, this is basically what we actually need. And let me don't forget, we also need a syringe tip. Yeah, a syringe tip is going to be where the fire is going to be lighting out. The fire is going to be lighting on the tip of the syringe. So that is a hot component which you're going to be using in this project. Let's quickly go to the next one. Now, first off, I have been seeing lots and lots of videos on YouTube creating this procedure, like using water to create hydrogen gas which is actually flammable and actually used to ignite fire or something like that. And they are very awesome videos on YouTube which I actually found like so, and I decided to make that same project. So now here's how it works. We have a couple of bolts and going to be inputted, 6 of them in my case, and which are going to be inputted into a water which is mixed with salt. These bolts are going to be connected 3 is going to be connected to positive, while 3 is going to be connected to negative. Now, connecting these terminals to a battery of 12 volt or a power supply of 12 volt, we can generate some kind of bubbles inside the water. This procedure is actually breaking down the water molecules. Now, these bubbles are actually what we get as the hydrogen gas, which actually flows to the top and goes to the syringe, thereby creating the fire in place. This is basically how it works, and this is basically how everything is done and set up. I'm just going to set you to the process on how I did mine, and also how you're going to be arranging yours, and also how you're going to build yours at home. So do all to stick around, subscribe to the channel so that you'll be notified for more educative videos like this. And let's go to that. Okay, now first off, we are going to be taking our container and we are going to be boring 6 holes which we are going to be inputting or inserting the 6 nuts as so. Here right here, I actually bored 6 holes which are going to be inserting the 6 nuts, and yes. Now, we are done inserting the nut. What is next? We are going to be connecting 3 of these nuts together and the other 3 together. 1, 3 is going to be served as the positive, while the other 3 is going to serve as the negative. Let's do that. After all the connections are done, the next thing which you actually need to do is to glue the nuts to avoid water from flowing out. Yes, because we are going to be putting water into this container, so we don't want to end up in the case of putting liquid into the container and we find out that the bolt, the place which actually put the bolt right there, is actually leaking out. So we're going to be using hot glue gun, hot glue which I have right here, to fill up the spaces to avoid leakage of water. And let's actually do that in place. Okay, we are done gluing everything and we observed that water didn't come out, and which was a success. Now, the next thing we should actually be doing is, I didn't mention the connection of the 3 nuts in place are going to be done by this thin wire. Yeah, by this thin copper wire. I'm going to be connecting it together to the 3 bolts and also be doing that in the other bolt. So we're going to be having 3 connected together. Now, we are going to be using these wires which I actually showed in the intro of this video. the positive and the negative to connect to the end of the wire of the one side of the three boot and the other side of the three boot, as I actually said. If you don't understand what I'm actually saying, let me know in the comment section and I'll explain it much better for you. Okay, now the syringe mount. Now the syringe mount is going to be used at this side of the container. So we are going to be boring another hole at this side of the container to input the syringe and also gluing it up to avoid no air loss or anything like that. So when the water is being broken down, when the battery is connected to the boat, when the bubble process is going on, the bubbles actually goes to this side of the container, passing through the syringe, lighting up our fire, in other words, igniting our fire and making our project a success. Let's go to that and let's actually test the project. We are really, really excited. If you really like this video, again, do well to subscribe to the channel because we're going to the interesting part. Stay tuned. Now, I know I actually explained a little bit on how this procedure actually works, but let me break it down for you guys again. Now, the bolt which I'm actually using, in my case, the six bolts which I'm actually using, three connected together, the three which is connected together is going to be connected to positive, then the other three is going to be connected to negative. Now, these bolts actually act as electrodes which are inserted into the water. Now, normally, I said in the intro of this video that we are adding salt into this water. Now, the reason of adding the salt into the water is to increase the conductivity of the water as so. Now, when powered, the current splits the water into gases, creating hydrogen as a bubble. Yeah, hydrogen is created as a bubble. If the power supply is being connected to this bolt, the water actually creates some bubbles which are actually generated from the bolts, as you can see. Now, these bubbles are actually hydrogen which we get from the negative side of the plate. Yeah, the negative side of the bolt which are actually connected to the battery. Now these bubbles actually flow to the top of this container, thereby flowing through the syringe which we got an output of igniting a fire. So the main thing that actually ignites the fire is actually the hydrogen gas. So we need the hydrogen gas which is actually flammable and actually ignite the fire. If you really don't understand it, let me know in the comment section and I'll explain it much better for you. This is basically how it works. Let's do more testing of our project. As you can see, we got our flame out of the syringe tip. Not that big, not that large as you think, but anyways, we still generated a little flame, ignite fire out of this salt water stuff experiment, which is very awesome. We can get a big larger flame if we are able to store the hydrogen gas into a container for a while. Then we could get a better flame. Just want to say thank you very much for watching the video to the ending. I hope you really like this video. If you learned something new and you got an idea, subscribe to my channel, it really means a lot to me. And you know what to do, support me on Patreon for more interesting videos like this. And also go check out my GoFundMe account, which I actually created on getting a new device using my sister's device in this video. Thank you so much for supporting, and I'll see you all in the next one. Stay classy.